professional Hannah Storm, Randy Scott, continuing with you on this Sunday. SportsCenter college basketball analyst Allen Cuff is here with us as well. Sometimes a top five matchup can get a little lopsided.
I mean, listen, you figured this was going to be tough for number one Tennessee, right? They're going into a very hostile territory. Kentucky coming off a loss, haven't lost back-to-back home games under Coach Cal. Right. So let's take a look at it, shall we? Right. So let's talk about Ja Morant, and obviously he's not going to be able to decide until the spring.
Well, yeah. Sorry, they got to win, but those two got to do some stuff.
But that's what he said. He wants to concentrate on that, put the thought of the draft aside. So his 141,000 Twitter followers will have to wait.
Yeah, it's fine.
Sadly,
it'll be soon over a million, I'm sure.
Very soon. Thanks. Great to be with you this morning. Thanks.
All right, back out with Dallin Cuff here. Tennessee, no answers for Kentucky, especially in the second half. How much should we take away from that loss with this team, the Vols, moving forward?
I think the biggest concern is this team have to win a championship.
As you say, rematch in 2 weeks in Knoxville. Certainly the Vols going to feed off that crowd, and Kentucky's got a couple of heavyweight bouts between now and then. We'll see how dinged up they are. Let's get to Duke yesterday.
I guess Duke figures to be the new number one. We'll find out tomorrow on the noon SportsCenter.
Pretty much.
And we'll see you back in a bit.
Be back in a few.
All right, revisiting our top stories here on SportsCenter. And how about a throwback tribute in the slam dunk contest last night?
Yeah, the Thunder's Hamidou Diallo getting some help from Shaq. Shaq was a would-be rapper, and then he brought a real, big-time rapper, Quavo, to kind of seal the deal.